Hey, hello everyone! Please remember to subscribe to Unrelent Gaming for the latest in Dragon Ball news and information! Also, please remember to turn on notifications if you want to see Bulma's titties!
The Tournament of Power continues as we move forward with the reintroduction of Super Saiyan God Goku within the Tournament of Power as Universe 6's legendary assassin Hit faces off against the Pride Troopers, sealing his fate until the aid of Goku, in which creates the dream team that we've all been waiting for in Hit and Goku having to work together to battle against the common enemy. What's going on, Dragon Ball fans? Welcome to my Dragon Ball Super episode 104 review entitled The Ultimate High Speed Battle Begins. Goku and Hit join forces, leading into next week's exciting episode of Dragon Ball Super episode 105, in which is bound to be another earth-shattering episode, as this episode introduced a form that we never thought we'd ever see again in the world of Dragon Ball Super. We had its pros, we had its cons, and the battle against Dispo was definitely best suited for the reintroduction of the Super Saiyan God form. And again, I do want to say that if you guys are new to this channel, then be sure to go on ahead and punch that subscribe button and turn on notifications. That way you guys can be notified whenever a Dragon Ball video is posted onto this channel. Hashtag notification squad to be up to date with all the latest in Dragon Ball information. Dragon Ball Super episode 104 is now officially in the history books, and this had to have been, if anything, the most anticipated episode of the Tournament of Power thus far. Why? Because we finally get to see Hit in action, we finally get to see Goku in action, and to everyone's surprise, the outcome of this battle was best suited for the narrative carrying on into episode 105. So we start the episode off exactly where we left off, with explosions happening all throughout the background, and we see this very ominous shot of Hit and Dispo. Now, Dispo seems to recognize who Hit is by addressing him of Universe Number 6's Hit, addressing that he is Dispo from Universe Number 11's Pride Trooper group, and that he is here to stop Hit's time skip. And the way this was all portrayed and put together was awesome, because Hit pretty much pulled his hands out of his pocket, he got into position, Dispo was in position, and from the background, we see Khalifa and Kale, and Khalifa pretty much urges Kale that there's nothing really to worry about because Hit's time skip is pretty much sufficient enough to be useful in this fight. But instead, what was interesting was as soon as Hit was going to use his time skip, he got rocked in the face. And the way he got punched in the face, he flew black. I mean, you know, he broke the ground behind him, and Ciampa was just panicking, and for obvious reasons too. And with that, we see Hit pretty much, you know, holding onto his face, and he gets up because he didn't believe as to what had just happened. So I want to retract my statement in saying that Dispo was complete fodder, because it looks like he is the only one among the Pride Trooper group thus far that has proven himself to actually do something against a very high caliber fighter. But what's also interesting to note was the music that went along with this, because it was very ominous, especially in the beginning. So we see Hit, he's finally about to use his time skip, and everyone's panicking. But of course, Dispo is pretty much, you know, congratulating Hit for not going down, you know, with the first hit. And then as they're about to collide, out of nowhere, Hit just, you know, does all these flips and whatnot, and he falls on down to the ground, and Ciampa's freaking out, because this is Ciampa's top guy, and his top guy is getting John Cena'd right now. So we see how even, you know, Vados is saying, well, this is very unexpected, and we see how even Vermont, or Belmont, however it is you want to call him, he actually says to the angel that in fact this is how Dispo operates. He is the Sonic Warrior, talking about his immense speed, and even the Omni King couldn't even see Dispo's attack, and the Grand Priest shows them a rewind footage of what actually happened. This is the first time we're seeing this. So apparently enough, there's cameras in the tournament, because they have like some sort of like replay feature. And I will say, Hit's time skip was nothing compared to this dude. He is so fast, he's able to actually outmaneuver time skip. And that says a lot in and of itself, because from a distance, we see how Topo, the little frog Pride Trooper, and Jiren are pretty much observing this, especially Jiren, because the way Jiren looked here, I'm sorry, but he looked like a beast. So we see how Dispo is looking down on Hit, and I will say, man, this entire portrayal was definitely needed to elevate Dispo's character. Now, with that being said, we see how Hit is beginning to get enraged. He has like some sort of like, you know, flashback of him having to go alongside with Dispo and having to get caught with the second attack, and he's remembering this, so he's trying to determine as to what's happening, in which case later on he begins to tell Dispo, and Hit figured out Dispo's moves, that the fact that he's faster than the movement before Hit can actually use time skip, and that he can momentarily become thousands of times faster. So that is Dispo's ability, the ability to become thousands of times faster than even time skip. That's what gives him the advantage. But what follows is Hit tries to challenge this, and he ends up crashing into a rock. And Dispo, although I don't believe that he is significantly stronger, he definitely is faster. Now the thing with Hit is we get to see how finally he was trying to figure out his movements, and we see how Dispo is just moving so fast, like there's several different, you know, clones of him. You can't really tell as to what's happening. But then even as Hit assumes that Dispo is moving, he never moved to begin with. He was just there observing Hit the entire time. That's how fast he is. He was able to create this illusion that he was moving during that moment, but he wasn't actually doing anything at all. He was just standing there and pretty much mocking Hit in all of his displays, which is terrifying. But finally, as they begin to really engage, there were some really cool shots. If you paid attention, Dispo headlocked him, he kicked him around, he was legitimately throwing down with him, and he was faster. So I really doubt that he's stronger, but he was fast enough to combat Hit to the point where Hit was actually having such a difficult time. Being as fast as Hit is, Hit was trying to legitimately throw down with him, and during a certain point, it looked like Hit was slowly, very slowly, starting to catch up. And this whole time, Jiren is silently watching. His eyes were beginning to squint because he knows that at this given point, Hit is improving, and he's actually kind of able to momentarily try to keep up with Dispo, in which Topo tries to send out his other Pride Trooper to assist Dispo during the situation. Now, Hit lands by the edge of the ring, and Hit still can't dodge Dispo's attack because he needs to prep before using time skip. That's what actually, you know, gave Hit the advantage to a certain point, but there was a certain instinct where, you know, Dispo went for the attack, and Hit finally moved, you know, so fast enough to where Dispo threw a punch. He went right through Hit, and as he's about to go towards the edge of the ring, this is where teamwork comes in, because the little frog Pride Trooper pretty much saved Dispo from getting ringed out. He caught him in, like, these, you know, glowing webs, and he was able to rappel him back into the ring. So that was the advantage that, you know, was given to Dispo after pretty much having to go right through Hit. And at this given point, it's down to the two of them having to throw down with Hit, as Hit is watching all this. And I swear to you, we see the way Topo was talking, and Topo was pretty much addressing, you know, Hit and using dimensional, you know, tricks to his advantage, in which they're beginning to learn. And I love the overall portrayal of this. And I'm telling you right now, Dispo is slowly becoming my favorite, because between him and the frog, Dispo was definitely something else, because the frog dude didn't really display much. But either way, you know, Hit challenged the both of them in saying bring it, and we see how Kunchi, I believe his name is beginning to use his whips and his ropes to allow Hit to pretty much stop himself as weapons in order for Dispo to get the shots in. And as soon as Hit is moving, you know, we see how Kunchi is using these attacks to catch Hit. And I'm telling you right now, even with Dispo's, you know, speed, we saw how Kunchi was using, you know, everything he was doing to his advantage in allowing Dispo to just throw left and right, kicking him and whatever. And, you know, Ciampa, he had like this giant horn, and then he was just blowing it. He was just like, come on, Hit. He was rooting for his fighter. But even while all that's happening, Khalifa and Kale are watching this, and Khalifa's just surprised as to what's happening because she's never seen this from Hit before. But finally, just as Dispo was going to deliver the final blow, in comes Super Saiyan God Goku. And I'm telling you, his introduction was, it looked as if like Dispo hit a fiery wall. And, you know, Hit replied by saying, I don't need your help, with Goku having to say, I'm not helping you, I was just itching to fight them the entire time. And we see how even, you know, Beerus and Whis are saying that Super Saiyan God is faster than regular Super Saiyan, but he's using less energy than Super Saiyan Blue. So all I have to say to those who, you know, doubted me was, haha, because I told you so in the manga. In the manga wasn't lying. So they confirmed that Super Saiyan God uses less energy than Super Saiyan Blue, which was why he needed God in order to fight these dudes. In which we finally get to see Super Saiyan God collide against Dispo, and he's trying to use instant transmission, and Dispo's fast enough to even move, you know, throughout that. So we get to see how finally, and I am telling you all right now, Goku tries to teleport, but Dispo is actually fast enough to catch him, and then he goes blue for a moment, and he attacks him. Very similar to the manga, they're finally using what's being done in the manga in the anime. So I can't tell you how many times I told you guys so, but I told you guys so. Go back to my previous videos and you will fact check that I compared the manga to the anime, and I was 100% right. Because in the manga, Super Saiyan God was only used momentarily to go into blue, you know, just to strike in that moment during Dragon Ball Super, manga chapter number 22, and of course 13. But either way, Hit finally fires off a singular shot at the frog, and he incapacitates him. So it was crazy to see Belmont's or Vermouth's, you know, reaction, because Hit pretty much just stops him right there after he was using all these whips and ropes to, you know, momentarily hold Hit down. You know, we see how finally Hit uses that one punch, that one shot, to punch him right in the ribs, and that was pretty brutal. And all the way in the distance, we see how Goku Super Saiyan God is fighting against Dispo, and Dispo's giving God Goku a run for his money. Why? Because he's faster. He is incredibly faster. And even Goku at this very point, having to be right next to Hit, we see how, you know, Goku thinks that these Universe 11 guys are just as tough as he expected. And even with that, you know, as he's talking to Hit, Hit moves and he finally catches Dispo with a thunderous, and I mean a thunderous shot to the chest. And, you know, as he hits him, you know, by pretending to use time skip, he switches out by using another attack momentarily to catch Dispo during that moment. So just as Dispo thinks he's going to use time skip, Hit did something else and he just clocked him right in the ribs. And, you know, Dispo looked like he was going to crap himself. Meanwhile, Goku intentionally steps all over the exploding wires in which the little frog Pride Trooper put out, because they were pretty much traps. And as Goku steps on him, he's using Super Saiyan Blue back and forth, back and forth. So even though, you know, Super Saiyan God uses less energy, we still get to see Goku use blue momentarily to get past the webs, and he just clocks this dude. So either way, by the end of this was a fantastic episode. You can't deny that. And even as Goku uses Super Saiyan Blue, he delivers a shot to this poor little dude. He goes flying into the rocks, and with all that being done, we see how, you know, Goku's firing off all these blasts and stuff, and Dispo, all while this is happening, you know, he's trying to attack Hit, and finally Hit has the upper hand. Why? Because he knows about what Dispo can do. You have to study your opponent, because that's exactly what Hit did. And as Dispo's trying to punch him, he does the exact same thing that he did against the Mafia boss. And that was pretty much stop time momentarily. And Hit says that the fight's already over, and he offers to throw Dispo out of the arena, and Dispo refuses. But now he's starting to use time skip for real and manages to nail Dispo several times. There were actually several shots. They reused several shots from the tournament with Universe 6 and 7 Vegeta in order to retell and reuse that, you know, animation when Hit was knocking out Dispo. Because if you guys remember when Hit was beating up Vegeta, they reused that exact animation. But this dude Hit, man, he grabs him by the ears. And what's funny about this is the Pride Troopers are in trouble, because in the beginning they had the upper hand. By the end of it, Hit grabs him by the ears, and Dispo is saved yet again by Kunshi, who advises, you know, for them to retreat. And, you know, because they have no other alternative but to help each other out. So they're wounded, they're obviously hurt, and the both of them cannot do anything against Hit and Goku, because at this point they have the advantage. But by the end of it, Hit just had enough of Kunshi. He finally moved behind him and he wrung him out. So Kunshi is gone. It is now down to Dispo, Topo, and Jiren. And Dispo vows to get revenge in the name of justice, but Topo says that it's all about survival now, because now it's like they have no other, you know, means but to actually step in, because their entire squad is gone. All the fodders are gone, and the real, you know, tough guys are finally in here, and they're actually holding their own. So Dispo is retreating with Topo, and he's pretty much talking about this being a battle of survival. Like, they have no other choice but to step it up. So he manages to escape, he regroups with them, and Topo looks very, very angry. I really hope that we execute and see more from him. And Jiren again is looking out in the distance, and Goku powers down, he's talking to Hid, and the episode pretty much cuts from there. So it was an incredible moment. And I mean, even towards the very end, as Goku is talking to Jiren, we get to see, according to Herms, that Hid goes away without fighting Goku in exchange for Goku's help. But Goku says that next time they're gonna settle things for sure. So there is going to be a match between Hid and Goku at some given point, but for now, in exchange for his offer, he leaves Goku alone. But I would like to hear your thoughts down in the comment section below. What are your overall thoughts on Super Saiyan God being reintroduced in the Tournament of Power? What are your overall thoughts on Goku having to team up with Hid? What are your overall thoughts on the battles? And what are your overall thoughts going forward into Dragon Ball Super Episode 105? I am going to be doing a breakdown video further discussing this alongside doing a prediction video later on today. So I hope you guys tune back in for that again. Thank you all so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed the episode. The episode was very solid so far. It was a very good episode in comparison to the other episodes we had in the last couple of weeks. But again, post your comments down below, guys. Thank you all so much for watching. If you guys are new to this channel, punch that subscribe button, guys. Turn on notifications. Leave a like down below if you guys enjoyed. Tune back in for more. For me, this was a definitive episode. If anything, one of the main highlights for the Tournament of Power, because we've gotten other things before, but I don't think nothing like this, especially having to go back and using one of the main forms from Battle of Gods, in which it reintroduced so many awesome concepts and things about the episode. So I would have to say this was a very good episode. It's not because I'm fanboying out, it's because we got to see more from Goku, from Hits, from even the Pride Troopers in telling a really good story. So post your comments down below, guys. Thank you all for watching. Tune back in for the breakdown, and I'll be seeing you all down in the comment section below. Have a wonderful day, guys. Peace.